held it.
So this next song has a little bit of an introduction because it was really written about these five people up here, and so you get the story. In the beginning, Lindsay Buckingham lived in San Francisco. Stevie Nicks lived in Los Angeles, but her parents were transferred up to San Francisco in 1965. I have slipped into the second person. I was a senior and he was a junior. I met him one time and we sang a song together, and then I never saw him again until the end of my second year of junior college, which was 2 full years. And he was in a band, and his band called me and asked me if I would like to come and sing in their band. And I was like, sure, I would love that. And so I signed up, and within 2 days we were in, they were already in rehearsal, I was in rehearsal too. And very, very soon after, this band was opening for very, very big acts in San Francisco. And mind you, San Francisco in 1965, 66, 67, 68, and 69 was the best place in the world you could be if you were a musician or an artist of any kind. And there we were, it was like we landed in a spaceship in this amazing place. And so we started opening for really big acts, and this was a very big deal, even though for us it just sort of happened, but it was a huge deal. It didn't just happen for everybody else. So we were opening for, yes, I'm gonna brag a little bit, but 75,000 people, Jimi Hendrix at the Santa Clara Fairgrounds. Monterey, Carmel, Santana, right before the movie Woodstock. Chicago at the Fillmore West, which was their biggest record, so it was huge. And the last one I'm going to tell you about, because there were so many, is we were actually stuck in Lodi with Creedence Clearwater. And we were stuck in Lodi, our carpool. So that's where Lindsay and I really learned a lot of this, and were able to walk into Fleetwood Mac fairly easily. In those days, you were 8th on the bill, better than nothing, and the perk was you got to stand on the side of the stage and soak in all this amazing stuff that these artists were doing and learn from them. So we did, and we got as much of it as we could get. And while this was all happening, we were making pretty good money. I was going to college still, insisted on by my parents, and I got to keep this particular money. I saved it up. And I heard about this amazing store in downtown San Francisco that was called the Velvet Underground. And this is where all the rock and roll women, and I'm starting to remember back, some of the rock and roll men went to get their clothes. They could afford it. So I thought, I'll save my money for, you know, a couple months, and then I'll go up there and I'll buy something. So I go up there and I find this store, and I walk into the store, and I think it's going to be a bigger store. It's a tiny little store, and it's full to the rafters with the most amazingly beautiful things. And I stood there on this gorgeous hand-painted floor and said, I can't afford anything here. I don't even have to look. I know that there's maybe one thread of something I can walk out of here with. But what I realized was I'm standing on this hand-painted floor where I'm pretty sure Janis Joplin stood and Grace Lee stood. Most possibly Joni Mitchell stood, and it's, you know, it was an endless possibilities. And I'm thinking to myself, oh my God, I'm having like a premonition / seizure, because I'm not getting anything here, but what I'm getting is, I know something is coming from just standing on this floor. It's coming and it's gonna be big. And later on down the road, I realized that what I saw and felt on that day was Fleetwood Mac, was Chris and Lindsay and Mick and John. So the reason that I'm telling you this very long drawn out story is because we were just kids in San Francisco. We had no idea even really what we were doing. And if you have a dream and you believe in it, and people will always stand in your way and say, no, no, you can't have that, you have to do this or go that way, and you believe in your dream, don't ever let anybody stand in your way and tell you you can't do it, because that is a lie. You can do anything you want. You just have to work hard and focus and say, this is my dream, this is my world.